Hello guys, hello and welcome back to another episode of FTB Infinity. And what we are going to do today and where are we? We are in our new base, well basically over our new base. And this is the canyon that we discovered and down here is the way to our new base. So this is the top of the base. Yeah, and by the way, I don't know why there's fire. Oh, because... Right. Oh, this is the... It's the oil. Yeah, it's the oil. So... what I did here are little platforms for gardens. I will actually destroy all of this because it didn't quite fit in perfectly, or it didn't turn off up like I wanted. So we are going to destroy this, and I will do this off camera, but for now we can keep it, because we are not going to use this today. Today, what we are going to do is right here. And what is it? Well, basically, it's going to be a tower. Yes, it's going to be a tall tower. And this is just some idea for design. And what will be in this tower? Well, in this tower, we are going to have the botania stuff. Yes, that's right. So I've been messing around with some ideas, with some blocks. First, I wanted to use this dream wood, but it's not what I wanted. It doesn't look right. It's just doesn't fit in. And then I actually discovered those frame living rock blocks, and they are kind of nice, and for tower that I want, they fit in perfectly, because I want this tower to be like a pure pure tower, something like that, something like a little bit too light, I guess. And yeah, I wanted this to be like a symbol of pureness, because botania is all about the flowers and mana. So we are going to use those living rock bricks, and this tower is going to have multiple floors. So you can see it's going to be like this. And on top, we are going to use this path block from the open blocks, because it kind of fits in nicely. I might raise this up by one block, because we want to have like the entrance 3 blocks wide. So yeah, I might raise this a little bit, but we are going to use this kind of path block. It's kind of look cool. And for the stuff that we are going to do here, it's kind of perfect. So yeah, I just wanted to show you what I am up to, and I guess I will finish this up. I still haven't decided if I want to have those bricks all the way to the top, because I've got loads of those mana steel blocks, and loads of those elementium and dragonstone blocks. So, oh yes, and I've got those pixie dust. Yeah, they are not good for anything. I was hoping for this to actually be crafting a block. So I've got plenty of blocks from Britannia, so I want to use them in this tower. And the next thing that I want to have, I don't want to have like a flat ceiling. So if we take a look here, and we actually want to have a cylinder. No, we want to have the dome mod. Oh, I went dome mod. Yes, so we want to have like this dome inside, and I might raise this. Oh, it actually, I do not have to. So this will be like a ceiling, like a huge dome, and on top of it will be another floor. So I want to kind of have like two main floors that will stick out of the ground, and the rest of it will actually be right here. So right here we will have the mana farm, because we need a lot of mana and we want to store it quite a lot. So under this will be the mana farm, and we actually can have now those elven mana spreaders, and I want to use those Gaia spirit Gaia mana spreaders, because they are much better than those elvens. So yeah, we are going to build Britannia Tower today, and maybe we can actually get into like the mana storage today. I don't know yet. Hopefully we will finish this tower today. So I will finish those walls. Well, basically it's not walls because we've got a lot of free space between, but yeah, I want to have it like this, like open areas with the water flowing down, maybe liquid. Maybe I will use some other types of liquid. I'm not sure yet. I need to figure out what liquid actually flows. Maybe we can use the liquefied, where I have my transmitter, the the energized glowstone. So let's just craft one, and we can take a look. I will shut this down off for a second. So does, oh, it's actually not flowing. Okay, so we can't use this, but we may be able to use something else. I don't know yet. So I will finish all those walls, and I will finish the ceiling of this room, and I will be right back. Okay guys, so are you ready to actually look, to take a look how it's turned up? Okay, so here we go. And right now it doesn't look that good, because we are looking from the outside, but when we actually take a look in the inside and take a look up, oh yeah, that's right, we can see the sky. And even if I take a block and I place it somewhere here, we actually still see the sky without those blocks. So that's amazing. Those blocks are the those inverted sky blocks. If I take a lever, lever right here, and I power some of those blocks. You can see they actually turn gray. So those blocks are pretty cool, and I wanted to have this, like, that you can see the infiniteness of the sky, and I want to have this as much open as I can. So as we will build up the tower, we will actually be still able to see the sky, so that's pretty awesome. And for the inside, I want to try something. Of course, I've got those petals, those petal apothecary, I don't know how to spell that. And I've got, actually we can put them right here, those wells, like that, and last one, like so. Right, so now, if we take a bucket, and we take some water from those. Let's grab more, actually. So we can fill those up. Yes, that's right. So those are, this is our kind of main room. And I want to try something that I never tried before, actually. We take some blocks and we'll go like this and place this. It actually doesn't look that bad. Really? Those ghost blocks again. Okay. So let's take this down and let's place this rope. Oh, it's actually glowing. That's great. That's what I wanted. That's exactly what I wanted. So we can place those lamps somewhere here, and they will actually glow. Yes, they are glowing just a little bit. Just a little bit. But we can have, and I think that they are too low. Let's extend this rope. Oh. I want to connect those why it's not connecting? Why is it not connecting? Okay, let's take down the whole rope. And let's go like that. And I guess, oh my god, it's not okay. Let's place the lamp and let's try this rope to extend. Nope. Oh, this rope is not connecting here too. So let's take it off and let's try it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I know where's the problem. I know where the problem is. I cannot move. Yes. I should. Because if you move in any direction, the rope will actually move too, so you can like have this rope in different positions, and this is looking cool. This actually look awesome. So let's place more of those ropes. Maybe one more, and like so. and star FPS drop. So we've got more of those ropes, so let's place them. And I guess we can place them right here too. Oh, I love how those lamps, you can actually turn them however you want. And they are glowing. So, awesome. I will craft more of those ropes. They are kind of cheap, so and this is looking good, very good. And by the way, if we take, for example, few of those reds, maybe some of those blue and some of those orange, and if we take them like so, and we'll do those petals, we can actually place them on the ground like so, and they will be glowing. So let's place a few of them right here, and some more. Okay, so now let's take some of those reds. Are they glowing differently? Yes, they are glowing differently, so let's place them. Great, and oh, we've run out of red, so let's place some blue. I guess right here, and place them right here. And maybe some of those black and some of those purple, I don't think so, those lime. Let's take some of them and let's see how they will look like. Place few of them down just to have idea of how it will look, and some here and some of those black ones. It's actually hard to see where's place or where's not, so we can get rid of this and take a look. Oh, does actually look good. It's actually looking good. And by the way, I want to craft some of those floating, some of those floating flowers. So I will hop back to base. Base room. Nope. Base. So let's hop into base, and we need some of those flowers. So seed. Oh, we've got only one more. You need those pasture seeds. Oh, I got some of them here. So we need to first glowstone. So let's take some of those glowstones and mystical. So definitely I want those reds. So let's craft some of those reds. I want those black. So let's take a black, maybe some of those blues one. And oh, those are looking pretty. So let's take those. And I guess we can do the orange one as well. So you actually need those glimmering ones to craft it, but now we can take dirt. And we can take those seats, yes. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 5, I guess. Can take because those are pretty. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. And 2 of those. So I will craft a whole bunch of those seeds. And now we can hop back. Let's take some blocks in our inventory. And we want to go like this. We actually cannot see the flower. That's not good. That's not good. So let's place it like that. Oh, I broke too many blocks. Oh yeah, that's looking good. And you know what? We can actually place them even higher. Let's take, for example, the red one. Because if we kind of like come to this room, we want to see a lot of those flowers hanging around. So we can place one like that. Maybe one like that. Yes. And over here one. We do not have this one. Let's place it another one here. Oh, maybe here. And right here. Like so. Like that. That. And let's actually place one right here, and another one right here. So let's take a look. Oh, this actually looks pretty. And I want a lot more of those flowers flying around. We can place one more, so let's place it right here. Great. So I want a lot more of those flowers just to flow around. And I don't like this one right here because it's kind of like in the way. This actually look pretty cool. And I will craft a whole bunch of those ropes so we can add more of those paper lanterns. Yes, paper lanterns. And I need to check how much time do we actually have for today's episode. And I feel like there should be something in the middle. And I don't know what. Well, never mind. So I will look how much time we got for this episode. And maybe we'll be able to start our mana garden or mana, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, I will take a look and I will be right back. Alright guys, so we've got few minutes left, and I want to show you what I've done with this room. So basically, I add this altar or this terrestrial agglomeration blade. What this does is that if we take one of each dose and we drop them right here, You can see those sparks are taking mana from our pools, and we can craft those terrestrials ingot. So, with those few minutes left, I want to show you how I plan the mana creating room or whatever. We'll be using those hydrangeas, I don't know. So basically, if I take, let's see, glass. If I take glass and few blocks, so those flowers are taking the water source, and they are converting it to mana. So what we want to do is we want to have water sources like that. Imagine that the glass is water source, and we want to have this hydro plant, whatever it is. Okay. That was a long freeze. So we want to have this plant in the middle of those blocks. So we surround it with the water source blocks. And right here, we'll have another water source blocks. Like so, and of course we will have another here, and so on. So we will have those flowers with the source blocks all around it. So like that, it will actually suck lot water around, and we can then have those mana spreaders taking the mana to wherever we want. So we'll do it like this, and we will do it if I just remove all of this, give me that, and replace this dirt. So if we will build this under this room. So let's break this block. So we will build this under our room. So right here, I will have a lot of those hydro plants that are making mana. No, this is not the way out here. And we'll have those sprayers feeding those mana pools. And then we take few of those spreaders and we'll have them in here somewhere, taking the mana up by one, so we can have mana in the next floor. So that's the plan. Hopefully those mana spreaders work when there's a block between. We can actually test that. So let's go here. And if we take our wand and we block this, is it still gaining mana or not? No. Oh, it's not gaining mana. Well, I guess it is. Maybe. I don't know. Because this sprayer is definitely shooting that mana into it. But this one seems like it's not doing anything. Oh. That's because there was the plant. I don't know. So I will wait here and I will test this so we can then be for sure and we can have those spreaders in the walls. So yeah, I will craft more of those ropes, I will add more of those lamps, maybe a few of those flowers flying around. But basically, this room is finished. It's finished, yes. And let's take our wand. Oh, I can't pronounce it. So yeah, guys, this will be it for today's episode. The next episode, we'll build the mana room. And we'll continue with our Botania stuff, because I want to get into those Gaia things. And for that, we need a lot of mana and a lot of things. And of course, we want that elven gate or whatever it is. So yeah, I will do as much as I can in between episodes, and we can finish this project like in maybe 5 or 6 episodes. There's a lot of stuff that actually you can do with Botania. So I want to do all of that in this tower. Maybe we'll have more than 2 floors, I don't know yet. And I need to figure out the proper design for this tower, because I do not like Dreamwood. I really do not. So thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the episode, please leave a like or comment, and consider subscribing. It's always nice to see a new subscriber, and see you next time.